Just because you went to practice does not mean you actually got better. Don't be physically present, but mentally absent. Too many players kid themselves into thinking that half the battle is just showing up. Be where your feet are. Dominate the present task at hand before moving on to something else. And too many of you are too vanilla with your goals. You say things like, I hope I get better today at practice, or I hope I improve my skills today. That's not specific enough. Don't be so vanilla with your goals. Pick an area and commit to getting better at that area at practice. Don't go to baseball practice until you watch this video. Hey, it's Coach Justin from Ultimate Baseball Training, and in this video, I'm gonna share with you some practical tips that will help you maximize your practices and make sure that you're actually getting better each and every single day so that you can make the most out of your career. I really think these tips are gonna help you take your game to the next level, so let's get started. The first tip I have for you is be intentional. Just because you went to practice does not mean you actually got better. Too many players kid themselves into thinking that half the battle is just showing up. Well, I got news for you. Half the battle is not just showing up to practice and going through the motions in practice, especially if you want to play baseball at a high level, okay? So what I'm getting at here with being intentional is doing everything on the field in practice with a purpose. So when you're warming up, warm up with a purpose. Play catch with a purpose. Hit with a purpose. Do your defensive work with a purpose, with an end goal in mind of you're trying to transfer what you're doing in practice into a real game. But really what we're trying to limit here is we're trying to limit just going through the motions, because I think if we're all honest with ourselves, there have been certain practices or certain times when we're working out that we're not 100% intentional. We're not necessarily doing everything with a purpose. We are kind of just going through the motions. So the goal here with being intentional is to just be aware of it, aware of I need to be intentional, I need to do everything with a purpose, and trying to limit those days when you're just going through the motions. The next tip I have for you that's really gonna help you have better practices is be present. I always talk about the importance of playing the game one pitch at a time and staying in the present moment, right? But the problem is, those things don't just happen on their own. That doesn't just show up magically on game day. That's a habit that you have to work on and practice before it ever shows up in a real game. So the big key here with being present is don't be physically present, but mentally absent. Okay, don't be physically there, but mentally not there. Okay, too many times this is an easy trap to fall into. I'll give you a great example. During batting practice, you're doing on-field BP and you're just shagging balls. It's the worst for an outfielder, right? Infielders, you're a lot of times a little bit more involved. But infielders, you can fall into this trap too. But you're out there and you're physically there, your body's there, you're in the outfield, you're shagging balls, you're doing what you're supposed to be doing, but are you mentally there? A lot of the times the answer is no. You're thinking about your homework or what you have going on after practice, or you're thinking about a girlfriend situation, right? And I encourage you to be where your feet are. Dominate the present task at hand before moving on to something else. And that's great to apply into your life, because the worst thing is you're at baseball practice, but you're not 100% at baseball practice. And then you're at home, but you're not 100% home. And then you're doing your homework, but you're not 100% doing your homework either. You're giving like 75% of yourself when you should be giving 100%. So dominate the task at hand, be present both physically and mentally at practice, and I'm telling you, your results in games are gonna be much better. Next thing, commit to improving one skill. All right, this is another thing that's gonna make a big time difference in your baseball career. I want you to pick an area of your game that you need to improve, you know you need to improve this area, and commit to improving that area, that specific area at practice today. Okay, now it's important to note that this is not to say that you neglect other areas of your game. If you have a goal for, let's say I want to improve my curveball hitting, that's not to say that you don't improve your fastball hitting, or you know, focus when you're doing your defensive work, or you know, run sprints hard. You want to do all of that stuff hard. You still want to improve every aspect of your game, but too many of you are too vanilla with your goals. You say things like, I hope I get better today at practice, or I hope I improve my skills today. That's not specific enough. So you need to pick one area. A couple examples would be, I need to improve my curveball hitting today, or I need to work on backhand ground balls today. Again, that's not to say I'm not gonna work on ground balls hit right at me or hit to my forehand side, but get specific with one area that you're trying to improve. So I wanna improve my curveball hitting today, and then come up with a plan on how are you gonna make that happen? Well, I'm gonna show up to practice early and I'm gonna hit curveballs off of the machine. Then I'm gonna stay stay after practice later and I'm gonna have coach, you know, throw me some curveballs, a few rounds where I'm just seeing curveballs and working on squaring those up. Then he's gonna start mixing in fastballs and curveballs so I can recognize them out of the hand better. That's a concrete plan for how you're gonna improve, okay? So don't be so vanilla with your goals. Pick an area and commit to getting better at that area at practice. And I want you to imagine for a second, imagine if you just focused on one area and you got 1% better. Overall, your skill set, you got 1% better each and every single day. Imagine at the end of one season how much better of a baseball player you'd be, how much more skilled you'd be. And then compound that out throughout the rest of your entire career. How much better are you gonna be when you focus on getting better at one specific thing every single day and you get 1% better every practice, as opposed to just saying, I hope I get better at practice today. Okay, so we've covered some great stuff so far. This next tip is huge. This is the last tip I have for you. But at baseball practice, I want you to practice anchoring. What the heck is anchoring? Well, anchoring is a neuro-linguistic programming term. It's a high-level concept. It sounds crazy, I know, but I'm gonna simplify it for you because I really think it's gonna help you out. And guys, this is something that you're not gonna really hear hardly anywhere else, okay? So I really think it's gonna make a big time difference for you. But anchoring is the process in which a stimulus is associated with a particular experience, okay? A stimulus is associated with a particular experience. So an example would be, you know, anytime that I smell freshly cut grass, because I've been an athlete my entire life, it automatically brings me back to childhood memories of playing sports, okay? Whenever I smell the grill getting fired up, somebody barbecuing in their backyard, I think about being at a ballpark. Maybe for you, it could be a particular song brings you back to a childhood memory, or maybe whenever you smell apple pie, it makes you think of your grandma, okay? So that's what an anchor is. Now, you might be thinking, well, how the heck does this apply to baseball? Because we can actually create and develop these anchors. So whenever you're trying to recreate a particular experience, you can use anchors to do that. So let me just give you an example. Let's say you're in batting practice and you're absolutely crushing the ball. You just hit five seed line drives right up the middle of the field, okay? So what you can do is you can use a particular word or a movement or a physical touch. It could be a clap, it could be boom, it could be, you know, touching your hat like this and wiggling it, moving it around. But what that's doing is that's anchoring, that's associating hitting the ball hard with that particular word or movement or physical touch. So we can work on this in practice, and I encourage you to do this. So when you hit the ball hard, when you do something that you want to recreate in the future, anchor it with something. It can be anything, okay? It can be, try to make it something that you're actually gonna do in a real game. You know, you might not clap or whatever, but it could be something like boom, or that away, or something like that, where you can tell yourself, you know, this in the batter's box, or do this little physical touch in the batter's box without really looking silly, right? But you're associating hitting the ball hard with that particular thing. And then when you get into a real game, you can kind of flip the script and you can do that particular thing before you step in the box. And your brain has already associated those two things together. So it's gonna make that end result that you're looking for be that much more likely for you to achieve, okay? So I know it sounds crazy. It sounds like a super high level concept. There's a lot of jargon and scientific words around it. But really, at the end of the day, we're simplifying it. You already do these things. You already have associations. Like I said, when you smell apple pie, oh, you might think of grandma, right? So why not develop anchors that are actually gonna help you out in baseball, right? So whenever you're hitting the ball hard, or a pitcher, whenever you're, you know, hitting your spots perfectly, do something, you know, pick at your shirt, do something to anchor that in. Maybe you field a ground ball cleanly and you make a throw, and every single time you field it cleanly and you make a good throw to first base, you anchor it with something. It could be your ear, it could be this, it could be picking your shirt, it could be a word, you know, a movement, a physical touch. But I'm telling you, practice your anchoring. This is not going to be something, again, that just shows up in a real game, but over time, this is going to make a massive difference in your career. If you enjoyed this video, please hit that thumbs up button. I'd really appreciate that. It's just one click away and it would really help me out. So please smash that like button and subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already, because we're coming out with brand new baseball videos every single week and I don't want you to miss them. So subscribe. And last thing, hitters, I put together a free resource that I really think is gonna help you out. It's called the Contact Point Checklist, and you can download it 100% for free. All you have to do is just click on the link down below in the description. I'll also leave that link in the comments section, but what I've done is I've freeze framed the swing at the point of contact, and I've highlighted a few key areas that you need to focus on. You need to make sure that you have all of these elements incorporated into your swing at the point of contact in order to really maximize your bat speed and power and your consistency at the plate. So it's 100% free. I really think it's gonna help you out. Go download that right now. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.